All right, so for this review, I'll be starting off with size comparisons, then moving on to articulation, weaponry, transformation, shuttle mode, and finally my final thoughts. So starting off with size comparisons, when I first removed the figure from the packaging, I was impressed at how tall this figure is. And as an illustration, let me bring in the Voyager-class Soundwave from the Cybertron line. And you can see, yeah, he's shorter, but he's up there. He's about a Voyager-class size figure in robot mode. And then next up, I'll bring in the Seeker mold, and this happens to be Thundercracker. But you can see the size difference there. You know, he definitely is not a deluxe figure. He's pretty close to a Voyager, though. And that really is a good thing to see, because that means that the combined form is going to be quite impressive to behold. All right, for this size comparison, on our right, of course, is the Fans Project, not Minasaur figure. And on the left is the MakeToys Green Giant, or not Devastator figure. Now, yes, I am too lazy to take one of their limbs from each respective combiner and transform them into robot mode to give you an idea of a direct robot-to-robot comparison, but I can tell you that the Airbrush figure is quite tall. Okay, so let's have a close-up look at the figure, look at the sculpting, look at the paint. Starting with the head sculpt, really nice head sculpt. You can see it does have that sort of violet-purple translucent plastic for the eyes, which is nice. I do like how, design-wise, the shoulder armor sits on his shoulders. That's nice. And I like the fact that everything else is nicely sculpted. You can take a look at his chest. I got some silver paint there going on right here for the vents, I guess. Some nice detail here. Got some detail here on his arm. And, of course, the legs as well. Design-wise, I like how the wings for the shuttle mode wrap around his legs. And speaking of the back here, you have very little back kibble. You can have this up like this, or you can have it kind of tucked underneath here, which I kind of like. But there's a look at the back of the robot mode. And kind of a nice touch here, you have the thrusters for heels. Alright, so let's go ahead and go over articulation. The head itself is on a ball joint. Then you have the shoulder armor here, which are on ball joints, and that's really also due to the transformation process. You have arms that go out to the side, swivel at the bicep, bend at the elbow, and then you have wrist rotation, and then you have four fingers, which are on a single joint. Then you have the swivel at the waist, and you have this front skirt here that articulates up, allowing the leg to go forward. Swivel at the hip, bend at the knee. You really can't get the knee farther back than this, just due to the way that's due to the construction. And then you have articulation at the ankle. There's two points of articulation, really. There's a joint up here, so for the forward motion, and then of course going into the actual foot, you have a ball joint, as you can see there. So pretty nice articulation for Airburst here in robot mode. Okay, so let's look at the weaponry for Airburst. You get these two guns, which are identical. So certainly you can place them in the hands. And I will say that once you get them in there, even with the fist open, they stay in there really tight, which is good. So even with the hand open, no problem, the gun stays in. You can also plug the guns in on the side here if you want for that type of effect there. But my favorite two weapons are these rocket launcher type of weapons. You can see there's a little slider here, so if you don't want them deployed, or if you're transforming it into shuttle mode, you can certainly do that, but why would you want to hide that missile rack there? And these can go either on the side, like that, for that type of effect, which I like a lot. And you can angle the fin here down if you want. This doesn't have to be like that. It can be down like this. I personally like it like that. Now you can also take the missile pod and you actually bring out this peg here. It allows you enough clearance to actually place it in the hand. And again, it's in there securely even with the hand open, but you can see. And really probably what you want to do is maybe have this one on the outside, because you want to have, you know, this side facing the outside. You can have it like this, but you know, you get the idea. I personally prefer them on the forearms myself. So really, you could arm this guy up pretty well, because you plug in the two missile racks on the side, and then I'm sure you can see where this is going. You can plug in the guns on his fists. So that looks pretty cool, all well armed and everything. There we go. So pretty cool. I'm glad he comes with, you know, at least more than just two weapons. That's really nice. Okay, so let's get started with the transformation. First thing we're going to do is we're going to take the shoulder armor, rotate around on the ball joint, like that, and like that. And what essentially these two pieces are going to do, they're going to cover up the head and form like the nose section for shuttle mode. And they should just tab in place. Then you bring this assembly up, and see there's another tab, another slot. That should tab into place like that. So, coming back here, get these out of the way for now. You want to take the forearms here with the hands. What I find is you want to rotate the hands around so that you have them like that. That way this is as flush as possible. If you have the fist side or the top of the hand up, I find that that does not quite clear the plastic. So what I find is, like I said, rotate it around so that you have the fingers facing upwards as opposed to the back of the hand. There we go. And then these panels here on the side that come out. And then you're going to rotate the shoulder up and then situate the arms so they're like that. You can see already this is going to be this part of the side here. Pretty basic transformation, not too hard. Even I can sort of make it look easy on camera. So here we go, around like that. And the tricky part here is to get these panels to sit and tab into place. There's actually a little bit of a joint here, I guess, a hinge, and this has to go down. And what I find is the side here clashes with this side, and it may be just a tolerance issue that maybe could be improved upon. But try to get that down there. You can see it's clashing against the plastic, so you may have to free up the sides here to get that plastic to kind of just sit down there, and it should tab roughly into place like that. So we can do the same thing over here. Ah, a nice solid snap there. And then coming to the legs here, you want to get these wings all out. And you can see on the wing here, there's this other section here. And then you have one wing done. And do the same thing on the other leg. Again, one of the things I notice is these pegs do not stay in the peg holes, particularly on the wings. That's a problem on my figure. I think I can fix it easily enough with, you know, applying some super glue to the post there, but it's very annoying during the transformation. So you want to bring these thrusters back. And then coming to the feet, this is another point of contention that I have. This joint here, the clearance on this is really, really tight. And so you gotta just rotate it and hope you don't break anything. And then you bring it like that. You might want to hold on to this end so you don't put stress on this joint here as best you can, and rotate. I think the tolerances on this are too tight, but there you go. Then you want to get the legs straight again because they were kind of out of whack there. Tap together the legs like that, and then you want to bring together the collapse the legs like a G1 transformer almost. There you go. So we're missing something, right? Well, we got these weapon bits here. As I said before, there's a little sliding mechanism like that, which undeploys the missile rack. And then these tab into place. In fact, you might want to just go ahead and tab these together first. That would be the smart thing to do. And you have four peg holes, four pegs. Line them up like that. And then what you can do, and what I like to do, is you can apply the smaller guns here to the side. That's certainly one option. That's my preferred option. Or you can leave them off entirely if you want a more clean look to the shuttle mode. Also, you can have peg holes here on the underside of the wings. So you do have that option as well. Okay, so looking at Airburst here in vehicle form, it does look really good, and one thing that stands out right away is just the overall size of this figure in its vehicle shuttle form. Really nice. I'll show you a size comparison in a minute here, but let's go ahead and take a look at the details. There is a lot of nice sculpting detail throughout the figure here in shuttle mode. And I like the color combination again of the purples and browns. Really wouldn't be a color combination that you'd think would look good, but it actually kind of looks good. And then you have these silver accents as well, so that's nice. Now, in terms of the overall quality of how it fits together here in shuttle mode, I do have a problem, at least on my figure, with the wings falling off and the guns falling off. Now, you can store the guns here on the side, or of course you can store them underneath the wings. I just chose to put them on the side here, but that's just one option. So, really nice looking shuttle mode. So, as you can see in the front here, there is landing gear. It does have a somewhat movable wheel on either side. Back here, the landing gear really isn't landing gear. It's just sculpted into the foot, but it does provide back support. So you can see the figure does sit on the surface just nicely. So if you want to display your figure in shuttle mode, you can certainly do that with the landing gear. The landing gear is a bit difficult to get out. That's why I chose to show you with it deployed, but it simply goes back into what becomes the chest area here, as you can see. Now, as you're playing around with the figure here in its shuttle mode, it does have a tendency to come apart like this, just the way it's constructed. It's not a big deal, but it does happen sometimes. But, you know, most of the time it holds together pretty well, but if you're trying to fiddle with something really hard, it may just come apart like that. And so there's nothing really to hold it in place, no tabs or slots or anything like that. So that may be an issue for some people, but not a big issue to me. Here is a comparison with Fall of Cybertron Thundercracker / Skywarp / Starscream, the same mold, but you get an idea of how big this figure is. So this figure in its shuttle form is just about a Voyager class size figure, I would say. And finally, let me bring in the classic Seeker mold. I happen to have Thundercracker here in jet mode, and you can see there is a size difference there. So pretty substantial shuttle mode here. I do like that. As far as articulation goes, really the only thing that articulates is the thrusters here. They're on a swivel joint that can go up and down like that if you want. You can articulate the wings, but I don't see why you'd want to, but if you do, there is articulation there and there. Okay, so as far as transforming it into the limb mode, the instructions do tell us that you should start out with the shuttle mode and then go into limb mode. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take off these weapons here. You want to go ahead and extend out this like that. Go ahead and take off the top section here that pegs in. Now for the next step, they don't really show this in the actual instructions. They jump from like point A to point D. But what you have to do is take these panels here, get them out of the way to the back here, or the top as it were. And you want to take these sections here, take the flaps here, fold them up, and these arms kind of go like this. And then what you're supposed to do is take the torso, rotate it 90 degrees like that. You need to actually fold these wings around the legs. You can see that you make use of these hinges here to allow them to kind of fold around the legs. Next, go ahead and split the legs. Now, what you would do with the hand is you would actually place it between the legs here, close up the legs, and you'd have your complete arm. Now, as you can see with the instruction guide here, that is what you get with the figure. You do not get the hand. So the hand probably comes with the larger torso figure in this combining figure set. So there you go. And the next thing you're going to do, you're going to take the section here in the chest, flip this panel up, revealing the combiner peg. So as far as I can tell, this is the transformation into the R mode. I say as far as I can tell because I'm not really sure about the placement of these arms here, but according to the instructions, that's kind of where they're supposed to be, so I guess that's what the arm looks like. And of course, you can see that there'll be the elbow right here for the R mode with like a bend, I guess, and then a swivel there. So there you go, R mode for Airburst. Alright, so let's take a quick look at the packaging. The packaging consists of a sleeve, and then there's a box inside. So we'll take the sleeve off. Well, actually, I'll show you the sleeve first. A nice design here. I really do like that. Looks like we have a design here back of the combined form. But you can see very nice artwork on the front, with the Warbitron logo on the sides. Airburst. And here's the back of the box, and here is the actual box. As you can see, the figure would come packaged in robot mode. I've got the Warbitron logo, Airburst logo, WB01A set, and a nice picture of Airburst there, which is really cool. Side of the box, this side of the box. Oh, he's a sergeant. Okay, Marshal Master. That's kind of the first time I actually looked at the side of the box here. That's why I'm pausing about that. On the back, sort of like line art of robot in vehicle form. And that is about it. Here's the company information. So one point I really want to bring home is the transformation on this is simple, but it's satisfying. I really do like the way it transforms. It's not overly complex. It's just about right in terms of the transformation. It's interesting, but not overly complex. It's a figure where you can kind of pick it up, transform it, and not have to, you know, look at a instruction sheet or watch a video review to remind yourself how to transform it. It's very intuitive. It's very simple, and that's not a bad thing. So I really do like that. So I have to say, the size of the figure is definitely a positive for me, because this figure is quite substantial both in his robot form as well as in his alternate shuttle form. And you really can't say that about some of the other combiners. Particularly the one I have in mind is the Fans Project Knot Minasaur combiner. More to do with the individual robot modes and alternate modes, because they were quite small. And I guess there was some kind of restriction on size due to how much the figure would cost. But, you know, Airburst here is large, and it was actually about the same price as the Stunticon set from Fans Project. So I'm glad to see the figure is large both in its robot and its vehicle forms.